In the second example for proof by induction, we are going to compare polynomial growth with exponential growth, and we can sum up our result that we'll prove by saying that exponential growth beats polynomial growth. Let me go right to the proposition claiming that for all natural numbers, capital N, that are strictly greater than 4, so all natural numbers that are greater than 4, we have for them the following inequality. N squared is going to be strictly less than the nth power of 2, and 2 to the n. And we are going to prove this inequality by induction, using mathematical induction. So our proof will follow the usual recipe of three steps, the first step being the base case, means that we check the statement, check if it's true for the first smallest case possible. Well, in this case, this is n equals 5. Let's see. Well, for n equals 5, we have 5 squared on the left-hand side of the claimed inequality, and this is 25, of course. On the right-hand side of this inequality that we are claiming, we have 2 to the 5th power, which is 32, and indeed that is greater than 25. So the base case is now established. We can move on to the next step of our proof, which is the induction hypothesis, where we assume that the statement is true for some. We assume that the statement is true for some integer greater than 4, meaning, and we have seen that there is at least one such number, 5, so this is why establishing the base case is important, so our assumption is not an empty assumption. So assuming this means that n squared is going to be strictly less than 2 to the nth power. Finally, in our last step for the induction hypothesis, in the proof by induction, we are going to make the induction step. Meaning that we are going to show that the statement is true using the induction hypothesis for the next number n plus 1. Let's do that. So we'll start on the left hand side of the claimed inequality for n little n plus 1, that is n plus 1 squared. If we expand this square, we get n squared plus 2n plus 1. Now we recognize that in the first term, we recognize the left-hand side of the inequality that we have assumed, so we can use that inequality now. This is the point where we use the induction hypothesis. So step 2 is used at this point to say that this is greater if we have 2, we get something greater if we have 2 to the power n plus 2n plus 1. And now to finish off this proof, I'm going to use another inequality, which I'm not going to prove. What I'm going to assume here is that 2n plus 1, the second and third term, terms in this expression, are strictly less, the sum their sum is strictly less than 2 to the nth power. Okay, and I'm saying that this is true for all integers greater than 3, actually greater than 2. I'm not going to prove this. This is for you. It's something for you to think about. But when I apply this inequality, well, I leave the first term unchanged, and I replace the second and third terms, their sum, by 2 to the power n. So now I have twice 2 to the power n, which is 2 to the n plus first power, which is exactly the kind of inequality, the right-hand side that we were looking for. This proves that the statement is also true for n plus 1, and it concludes the proof, the entire proof. So let me warn you again that here I used an inequality which I have not proved, and this is for you to think about. I will tell you that you will need another proof by induction to prove this inequality. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one.